So you want to build the perfect Upwork portfolio to finally start landing those high paying clients. My name is Alec and I've been a freelancer since 2018. And these days I get paid on average about $85 an hour as a web developer. And today I want to share with you some advice because I do have a lot of advice when it comes to Upwork and portfolios. You know, when I started, after I've learned web development online, had like no experience, only a Udemy course on my resume, instead of going to get a job right away, I tried to get success on Upwork right away. But I didn't know how to, you know, build a profile well. I didn't have much of a portfolio. And so I started trying to find clients without really having a portfolio on my Upwork profile, or pretty much like the minimum on it, like just a few projects that I built on my Udemy courses, but nothing was purposeful. And so I tried finding clients for weeks and didn't really find any results. I didn't get hired at all. So what I did is I decided, hey, I'm gonna try to find a regular job. And after that, this is gonna give me the experience and the portfolio that I need to finally start making money on Upwork. And at one point I thought, hey, I think I'm ready to go back to Upwork. I think I have what I need on my portfolio to start building a good profile. And so I quit my job and I put all the websites that I made on that profile. I put all that I could, all the experience that I had, all my online certifications, everything. I made it as awesome as I could. And after that, I started getting more and more responses. You know, if I was to compare like how much results I was getting before I got that job and before I built that profile with a portfolio, like the results, the difference was absolutely insane. I went from having barely any responses to then having quite a few responses. And the only people who were willing to offer me a chance were people who were offering jobs that were paying way less than what I knew I deserved, and less than minimum wage if I counted all the time that I would spend trying to find these clients and having to do free work for them to qualify. And it is not by building a portfolio or by getting more certifications that I went from struggling to find clients on Upwork to where I am now, where I'm charging on average about $85 an hour. And I'm not the only person who's gonna tell you that. I mean, how many people are on Upwork who, you know, have started their career with normal jobs and have spent maybe 5, 10 years, 15 years in these jobs and then transition to Upwork? They have the experience. Some of them have degrees. Some of them have good portfolios. They put that and they make the best Upwork profile possible. And yet maybe they can find a few jobs, but it's very common that they don't manage to find high paying jobs, or at least enough high paying jobs to really make a good career out of Upwork. And once I realized that, what I started asking myself is, okay, if it's not necessarily the experience, if it's not the portfolio, what is going to finally get me these high paying clients? What is going to get me to the next level? The first thing I realized is that I was applying to just about any type of company that I could find. You know, I was looking on Upwork, I was looking at all these job offers, and I thought, hey, okay, this looks fun, this looks fun, this looks like something I could do, this looks like something I could do. And so I would apply to all these different companies without doing much discrimination, without really looking at which types of companies are likely to be willing to pay me a lot of money. And, you know, there's not gonna be too much competition. So, you know, if there's too much competition on some types of jobs, it means it's gonna be harder to land these jobs, especially getting paid a lot. And so I started thinking, okay, how can I find places where there's a bunch of people who are willing to pay a lot of money and not a lot of competition? The thing with Upwork is that the vast majority, okay, you really have to filter a lot if you want to have success on Upwork, because the majority of the jobs out there are from companies who go on Upwork because they want to have cheap labor. You know, the reputation of Upwork is the place you go when you want to find people who are willing to do work for cheap. In the eyes of a lot of businesses, Upwork is just the place that you go to find Indians or people from third world countries who are going to do this work for about minimum wage. And because of that reputation, Upwork attracts a lot of bad clients on the site that you actually don't want to be working with and that are never going to be willing to pay you a lot of money because that's not what they're on Upwork for. So you really have to understand that most of the jobs that you find on Upwork are not going to be for you. They're not jobs that you want to apply for, and they're not jobs that you should feel angry that you didn't get hired because they were bad clients to begin with that would never be willing to pay you the amount of money that you deserve, that would never be willing to pay me $85 an hour or what other of my clients are willing to pay me. Like, I got people who are willing to pay $115 an hour for my time. The second thing I realized is that there are different methods for finding clients. And, you know, just going with my gut instinct, doing the best that I could on Upwork didn't really yield results at first. So I started looking on YouTube, trying to find different videos, just like this video that you're watching actually, that could give me tips, could give me a bit of strategy to be able to find more success on Upwork. And again, it did help me somewhat. I got more responses, but it didn't yield me the results that I needed. What really changed everything for me was when I realized that, hey, I had been working as a web developer, you know, the job I told you about earlier that I got after I didn't find success on Upwork. And at that job, I was working at a web agency. We were building websites. And so I thought to myself, okay, I was working at this agency, we were building websites, but for us to be able to build websites, you know, the business had to find companies who wanted to hire our agency. So in other words, my boss had to find clients for the agency, just like any freelancer on Upwork or on other different platforms or using different methods, try to find clients for their freelance business. And so I started thinking, okay, why don't I try to just find clients instead of on Upwork? I try to find clients using the same methods that my boss was using, who was not using Upwork. And let's be honest, most agencies and most successful freelancers are not using, I mean, wildly successful freelancers are not using Upwork. And there's a reason for it. And when I started using the method that my boss was doing, I managed to find my first client in less than 10 emails who was willing to pay me $51.05 an hour. For me, not only was this a huge increase to the amount of money that I was making in that job, it was also a massive, massive increase to when I was on Upwork and couldn't find jobs at all. And the reason I've been able to find success is that the method I've been using is a method that, first of all, that targets companies that are willing to pay a lot of money and have a high likelihood of being interested in websites. So that means I don't have to waste a lot of time contacting a lot of different businesses because they have a high likelihood of being interested in my services. But second of all, they have a high likelihood of being willing to spend a lot of money. So it's a lot easier for me to find high paying clients. It's the exact opposite as on Upwork. On Upwork, you have a bunch of companies there, but most of them want to pay as little as possible. And second of all, what you need to understand is Upwork is probably the number one most used method of finding clients in the world for freelance developers. So that means not only are there very few high-paying clients there, there's a ton of competition. So they're very hard to get because, you know, other freelancers are gonna want to get these jobs as well. So I'm not saying that getting high-paying clients on Upwork is impossible. But what I'm saying is that getting a sustainable long-term career where you get consistently find jobs where you're getting paid what you deserve, getting high-paying clients is difficult. So what I'm here to tell you is, yes, you could build an amazing Upwork portfolio and maybe it's gonna give you some results, but there is a better way. There's a way easier way. And if you wanna learn how I find my clients, how I can consistently find people who are willing to pay me between $51.05 to $115 an hour and on average about $85 an hour consistently, if you wanna learn how I do that, I'm actually starting a new series of videos where I share with you exactly my methods of how I find clients. And that series of videos is going to start tomorrow. Okay, so what you want to do is subscribe and go check out the videos, the playlist that's going to start tomorrow. If you're watching this video like way in the future, don't worry, I'm going to put a link to the playlist in the description. With that said, I wish you a wonderful day and I'll see you there.